go directly that we are from a religious or a spiritual organization, mm-hmm. and we are here to preach something, mm-hmm. and then they will say no.
He'll not come. Yes.
It is not possible. That. But how do we approach? We have to approach like we are here to empower the students, mm-hmm. to give them some knowledge, to give them knowledge about our country, our mm-hmm. history, our culture. Mm-hmm. In this way, we have to bind them
together first. Words, yeah.
Through words and our first orientation class will be like we are here. We'll mix up all those things about your career, about your culture, about your country, mm-hmm. history, mm-hmm. etc. And we will slowly, on the further classes, we will slowly introduce the topic called conversion. Mm. Like this, in our society, if we can give new different programs like this, then I think we can attract these students, this youth. And what the situation here is that many people, local people or the common people are very much serious about the conversion issue. But there is no one to do anything because all the politicians have already been, they are driven away from our culture. And our educational system is such that there is no value for our culture, mm. and our scriptures.
Mm. It's all become science and math now.
Yes. So if we approach them, then we have to say, yes, our religion is scientific. We have to approach that way. Mm. And only then, if we make them some type of positive for us, then our extra classes, like about our Vedas, about our Gita, mm-hmm. about our yogas, we can then clarify them. We have to cite the examples of the US and the Europe. That is the situation here.
Okay.
When you say okay. that these scientists, these foreigners are now attracted toward this, uh-huh. then our society, is it?
Yes. Because what you're saying is we have lots of Western influencers.
Yeah. So one way we have to do is that Western is also seeking the Eastern philosophy. So why
yes.
not we?
Yes.
That is our approach nowadays.
Yep. Yep. I think that's an awesome approach. Because yes, we see in the society, right from our dressing to eating to living style, everything is changing to Westernization. People are assuming, right, like being... what Westerners are doing is the best, and that's why people here are adapting to that. So I think your approach of kind of, turning the table around to say even Westerners are coming this side gives them more.
And, about the conversion, the straight conversion, I think that has been, that has saturated. And when that fails, then conversion is being done by another ways. Become that, we are also Hindus, etc., then they will do another approach. Like this type of thing are also happening here. And the main issue is the educational institutions and our curriculum, where there is no trace. 99%, I think there is no trace of our Sanatan culture, mm. Sanatan scriptures. So that is the main problem here. Because what we see and what we listen from our elders and from our ancestors, that is just remaining. And that is just remaining as a part of the karma kanda, what we do rituals.
Yeah.
And the meaning of our ancient sages, scriptures, and those things, those philosophy is being fading away. And what I see is that our society is very vulnerable now. So we have to, if we can give counter approach to the conversionists, then we can do more progress. We can attract these youths, we can attract these people towards mm-hmm. ourselves through these ways. And mm-hmm. we can do, yes, our friends are very energetic, they are willing to do this thing.
That's great.
And this Youth for Shiva, maybe it has been 2 years, isn't it?
Almost like a Youth for Shiva.
But this idea was initiated through the activities of Sangha and Vidyarthi Parishad. And we learned a lot from these things. So I think our institution is independent, but our all the those visions are same as those of Sangha. And this we operate mainly in youth, as we say. But as a youth comes from the childhood, so we are doing Balviyas. And Sangha that and the Vidyarthi Parishad. From that we have learned so many things that it has given us the energy to do something. We have to do, and it has binded us to the all those Hindus around the world, Sanatanis. So we have been, we are not alone. That type of feeling is being among us, and we have maybe the energy to do something, to do something from local level, from ground level to anything, I hope, that we can do in the future. So I think we can do better.
Yep, awesome.